This time we will start with a right angle triangle. Then we will inscribe the circle inside this triangle in such a way so that the intersection point between this circle and the hypotenuse is dividing the hypotenuse into two segments with the length of 1 and 2. The question is, can we somehow calculate the area of the whole triangle? Of course, you can pause the video right now if you want to try this problem for yourself, and then come back and check the solution. Alright, so I'm going to offer you two different solutions for this one, and you're going to love the second solution because it is only going to take us 5 seconds to do it. But before that, let's do the first method, which is going to be the classical approach to this problem. We're going to start this method by first labeling all the vertices of the triangle as A, B, and C, and the center of our inscribed circle as O. Then we will also label the intersection point between the circle and the hypotenuse as D. Now, let's pull the radius OD, and let's label it as R. We know that the angle at the point D is a right angle. Of course, we know this by using a tangent of a circle theorem, which states that if we have a circle and the tangent to this circle, and we pull the radius to the point of tangency, this radius will always be perpendicular to our tangent line. So, we are going to use this in our case here, since the hypotenuse AC is the tangent to our circle. So now, let's rotate our radius horizontally to the right, and let's label the intersection point as E. The angle at the point E will also be the right angle. We know this by using the same theorem as before, because the line CB is actually tangent to our circle. And finally, let's rotate our radius one last time, but this time vertically down, and label the intersection point as F. Now the angle at the point F will be the right angle as well, by using the same tangent of a circle theorem, because the line AB is actually tangent to our circle. Alright, so now let's have a look at the quadrilateral OEFB. You can see that it has 4 right angles, which means that the angle at the point O must be the right angle as well. And since it has 2 of the same sides with the length of R, that means that this quadrilateral is actually a square. So we can conclude that the lines EB and FB are equal to R as well. Now let's try to find the remaining segments that we do not know. And we can do this by using one really interesting theorem of a circle, which states that the length of a tangents from an external point to a circle are equal. And I will label the vertices on the sketch on the right the same way as the sketch on the left to avoid confusion. So let's have a look at the line CD. Since the point C is an external point to our circle, this means that the length CE must be equal to the length CD, and it must have the value of 2. You can of course use the sketch on the right as a reference to confirm this. Now let's just rename our vertices on the right, and let's have a look at the point A. It is also an external point to a circle, so the line AD must be equal to the line AF, which has the length of 1. Now, let's just remind ourselves that the area of the right triangle can be calculated as the half of the product of its legs. So, we can use this formula in our case. And if we substitute the values from our sketch, we will get the following. Now, we can expand this and get that the area of our right triangle must be equal to r squared plus 3r plus 2 over 2. Now, we know that this triangle is a right triangle, so the Pythagorean theorem applies. So we can say that the leg AB squared plus the leg BC squared must be equal to the hypotenuse AC squared. Now we can substitute our values from the sketch and get the following. Now we can expand our terms by using the square of binomial and we will get the following equation. We can simplify this, and you can notice that 2 is a common factor for each term, so we can divide our equation with 2 and get r squared plus 3r minus 2 that is equal to 0. This is, of course, a quadratic equation, and you can use it to find the radius of a circle, which you can implement into the formula for the area and get the area this way. But we're going to do a little bit of a shortcut, because if you notice, this expression is really similar to the expression at the top, right? Only difference is that this expression at the bottom has minus 2 and the expression at the top has plus 2. So we can expand our equation at the bottom by adding 4 on the left and the right side of the equation, and we will get the following. Now you can see that the part of the equation on the left is exactly the same as the part on the top. So we can just substitute all that quadratic equation with 4, and now it's pretty easy for us to find the area, since the area must be equal to 2 squared units, and this is our solution. Alright, so this was a classical way to find the solution to this problem, but now, as I promised, let me show you the 5-second method to solve this problem, and you're going to love this one. So, we're just going to start our counter. Ready? Go! So, the area is 2 times 1, which means that area is equal to 2, and this is our solution. Alright, so I know what you're thinking right now. How the hell did this happen? And how did you just write those two numbers, multiply them, and get the solution that doesn't make any sense? Well, actually, it does make sense if you know something about the theorem, which I'm going to show you right now, and I'm also going to prove this theorem to you if you don't know about it. But before I do this, this would be a great time to invite you guys to like the video or subscribe to the channel if you enjoyed the content so far. Those stuff really means a lot to me. Alright, so now let me show you this really interesting theorem. This theorem only applies to a right-angled triangle. And since it applies in every case, I will just substitute the values of 1 and 2 with the values of P and Q, and let those be our segments. Now, this theorem is called the right triangle incircle tangent segments theorem. And I know that it sounds like a really fancy term and it's a mouthful, but trust me, it's a really easy and logical theorem. It states that in a right triangle, the area is equal to the product of two segments into which the point of tangency of the incircle divides the hypotenuse. In our case, this means that the area is equal to P times Q. But you're probably wondering, why is that? So, since in my experience, not a lot of people knows about this theorem, I will try to prove it to you so that you can see that it works every time. This theorem is actually an extension to Heron's formula, so we're just going to remind ourselves about the Heron's formula, where S stands for the semi-perimeter, which we can calculate like this, and A, B, and C are actually the sides of our right triangle. Now, let's work through our Heron's formula a little bit by putting everything to the square, and we will get the following. Here, let's have a look at the factors S and S minus C, and we will just focus on the product of those two factors. Now we will first substitute the value of S with our formula and get the following. Then, inside our brackets, we will expand C with 2 to get the same denominator. Now we can simplify by getting 1 over 4 outside the brackets and we will get the following expression. Now, if you take a closer look inside the brackets, you can notice that we have a plus b, which is common for both brackets, and also the c. But the sign is different. One is plus and the other is minus. So does this remind you of some formula that we know? If you thought about difference of squares, you are completely right. So we can rewrite this as the difference of squares. Now, we know that our triangle is a right-angled triangle, so the Pythagorean theorem also applies. So we can substitute the value of c squared with a squared plus b squared. And we can work through this by expanding using the square of binomial and get rid of the brackets, and we will get the following. Now we can simplify a squared and b squared, and we are left with AB over 2. Now, remember, since our triangle is a right-angled triangle, the formula for the area of the right-angled triangle is equal to the half of the product of its legs, so this means that this is actually equal to the area of our triangle. Now we can substitute the value of the product of the factors S and S minus C with the area of our triangle. And if we do this, we will get the following. Now we can simplify the area of the triangle on the left and the right side, and we will get that the area of our right angle triangle is equal to S minus A times S minus B. Now, let's have a look at our triangle once more. If we pull radius horizontally and vertically, we know from our previous method that the bottom right segments of our triangle must have the value of r as well. And also from our first method by using the external point of a circle, we know that the remaining segments are p and q. Now, let's use this by taking a look at the semi-perimeter, and let's substitute the values for A, B, and C in terms of our segments. We will get to the following. Now, of course, we can simplify this by grouping the terms, and finally, we can simplify by cancelling 2 as a common factor, and we will get that the semi-perimeter is equal to P plus Q plus R. Now, we know that the legs of our triangle are actually equal to the sum of the segments P and R and Q and R. So, we can use those three equations and substitute them into the formula for the area. And, by doing this, we will get the following. Now, we can simplify the left bracket by cancelling P and R, and we can simplify the right bracket by cancelling Q and R. And we are left with the fact that the area of our triangle is equal to the product of the segments P and Q, which is actually the proof of the theorem which we mentioned earlier. And if you're still not convinced in this, let me prove this in another way as well. I'm just going to save the fact that the semi-perimeter is equal to P plus Q plus R, and the legs are equal to P plus R and Q plus R. And let's start with the fact that this is the right angle triangle, so the Pythagorean theorem applies. Now, let's substitute the values of A, B, and C as the sum of the corresponding individual segments. And in this way, we will get the following. Now we can expand both sides by using the square of binomial, and then we can simplify by cancelling the common terms on the right and left. And if we group this, we will get the following. Now you can see that 2 is a common factor, so we can cancel 2 on both sides of the equation. And on the right side of the equation, we will pull R as a common factor. And we will get that P times Q is equal to R times the quantity of P plus Q plus R. But, if you remember, P plus Q plus R is actually the value of the semi-perimeter. So we can say that P times Q is equal to R times S. Now, let me remind you about one last thing. that the area of any triangle is equal to the product of in radius and the semi-perimeter, which means that P times Q must be equal to the area of our triangle, which again proves our theorem from the beginning. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this interesting problem, and I hope you enjoyed this theorem. So let me ask you, is this the first time that you heard about this theorem, or you know this theorem from before? Leave your comments down in the comment section. And also, if you found another way to solve this problem, please write the method down in the comment section as well. I always love to see how you found another ways to solve the same problem. And of course, until next time, see you all and take care.